So let us take up the next question. Write on next question. It is a question basically based on the effect of half-life on the reactant initial concentration and using that variation of half-life with the concentration for order of reaction determination. Okay, so write on the question. Okay. Inversion of Kirchhoff proceeds with constant half-life of 500 minutes at pH equal to 5. At 500 minutes at pH equal to 5 for any concentration of sugar. Full stop. However, if pH is equal to 6, half-life changes to 50 minutes. If pH is 6, half-life changes to 50 minutes. Then derive the rate law expression for inversion of Kirchhoff. Okay? So try this question yourself. It is a question based on effect of half-life or dependence of half-life on the reactant concentration, initial as well as order of reaction calculation. So think on this question. Try this question yourself first. Now to solve this question, what you can see here, reaction given inversion of Kirchhoff. इसमें दो पार्ट है क्वेश्चन में. पहला पार्ट क्या है, हाफ लाइफ ऑफ गिवन Kirchhoff प्रोसीड विद द कांस्टेंट हाफ लाइफ ऑफ 500 मिनट्स एट पीएच 5 फॉर एनी कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ शुगर. कि फॉर शुगर द कंसंट्रेशन इज नॉट अफेक्टिंग द हाफ लाइफ वैल्यूज. इट इज अ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. वी नो दैट टी हाफ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू रिएक्टेंट इनिशियल कंसंट्रेशन पावर n minus 1. This expression will help to find the order of reaction, nth order of reaction. For nth order reaction, half-life is inversely proportional to the reactant initial concentration power n minus 1. आपको order of reaction निकालना है. पहला क्या बोल रहा है, half-life remains constant for any concentration of sugar. इसका meaning क्या होगा, इसका meaning ये होता है कि रिएक्शन का ऑर्डर होना चाहिए फर्स्ट. इसका मीनिंग होगा कि रिएक्शन विल फॉलो ए फर्स्ट ऑर्डर काइनेटिक्स. कि सिंस फॉर द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन हाफ लाइफ रिमेंस कांस्टेंट फॉर एनी कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ शुगर. तो उसको आप देख लीजिए, तो हाफ लाइफ कितना आपका रिएक्शन का रहेगा, इसमें इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू रिएक्टेंट इनिशियल कंसंट्रेशन. तो फर्स्ट लगेगा शुगर के लिए, ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन is 1 for sugar because T half remains constant for any concentration of sugar. पहला बात. Second point लिखा है pH dependence. pH means concentration of hydrogen ions. When pH is 5, that means what is concentration of hydrogen plus ions? 10 to power minus 5 molar. Then what is T half? 500 minutes. While we take pH taken 6, concentration of hydrogen plus ion become 10 to power minus 6 molar, then T half become how much? 50 minutes. Then T half the reaction become 50 minutes. So we can take from here that T half is here 500 minutes. Now become 50 minutes on changing the concentration of hydrogen plus ions. दोनों में क्या relation आ रहा है? That concentration of H ions are decreasing 10 times. T half also decrease 10 times. So if I take the from this expression T half 1 into reactant concentration, let's say concentration of hydrogen plus ions power n minus 1. Is equal to T half in second case, first case, into H plus ion concentration power n minus 1 in second case. What is T half in first case? 500 minutes. H ion concentration 10 to power minus 5 power n minus 1. In second case T half 2 aapko diya hai 50 minutes. इनटू कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एंड 10 पावर माइनस 6 पावर एन माइनस 1, तो वी कैन टेक फ्रॉम हियर कितना है 500 बाय 10 या 15 इज इक्वल टू 10 टू पावर माइनस 6 बाय 10 टू पावर माइनस 5 पावर एन माइनस 1, ये कितना पावर हो गया इसमें 10 इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय दिस हाउ मच हियर सॉरी माइनस 5 बाय माइनस 6 हुआ, इसको मैं यहां पे लिखा इसको यहां पे ठीक करें माइनस 5 माइनस 6 दैट्स ओनली हाउ मच हियर 1 बाय 10 या 10 पावर 1 बाय 10 वाज में या 10 पावर माइनस 1 इनटू पावर n माइनस 1 सो दिस इज हाउ मच कमिंग हियर फ्रॉम योर ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन n यू कैन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ n फ्रॉम हियर माइनस एन प्लस वन इज इक्वल टू वन फ्रॉम हियर व्हाट इज एन वैल्यू जीरो सो ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन फ्रॉम जीरो ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन फ्रॉम जीरो फॉर हाइड्रोजन प्लस आयन कंसंट्रेशन व्हेन द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन जीरो फॉर एच प्लस आयन्स व्हेन यू कंबाइन बोथ द पॉइंट्स हियर व्हाट कैन बी रेट ऑफ इक्वेशन के कैन बी टेकन द रिएक्शन रेट कॉन्स्टेंट into concentration of sugar order 1 into concentration of H plus ions concentration power 0 तो 0 ना लिखें तो फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा so in this case rate of reaction will follow only concentration rate of reaction is given SK into concentration of sugar that is the reaction will follow here first order kinetics the reaction will follow here first order kinetics as a whole because n is the order of reaction coming 0 for hydrogen plus ions and for sugar order of reaction is 1 समझ में आपको आया कि नहीं आया पहला पार्ट क्या बोला है reaction proceed with the constant half life of 500 minutes at pH 5 for any concentration of sugar you change concentration of sugar half life does not vary that means for which order of reaction is there when n is 1 then T half does not depend on the reactant initial concentration whereas when we take pH is 5 half life is given 500 minutes pH 5 is concentration of hydrogen plus ion is 10 to power minus 5 whereas when pH is 6 the concentration of hydrogen plus ion become 10 to power minus 6 molar at this concentration of hydrogen ions pH become 50 minutes So the relation from here T half into A concentration power N minus 1 A is taken reactant H plus ions concentration power N minus 1 is constant On solving from here we get the order of reaction 1 sorry 0 for hydrogen plus ion concentration or the reaction taken here will follow as a whole a first order reaction with respect to sugar and zero order reaction with respect to hydrogen plus ions So I hope it is clear this question. Okay. So write the next question. Likhiye. The rate constant for a first order reaction A giving B. Write down. The rate constant for a first order reaction A giving B is 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 3 per minute. Per minute. 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2 per minute. Full stop. If initial concentration of the reactant is 1 molar, if the initial concentration of the reactant is 1 molar, then calculate, bit first, initial rate of reaction, bit second, the rate after 600 seconds, the rate after 600 seconds, bit third, rate after 75% of reaction completion the rate after 75% of reaction completion or bit aapka fourth diya hai the rate after 30 minutes the rate after 30 minutes okay so try this question yourself Now let us come on solution part. To solve this question, to find the rate of reaction, what we require? The rate of reaction can be given as concentration of rate constant into concentration of reactant at time t. Reaction follow first order kinetics. So to solve first part, what is initial rate of reaction? K is the rate constant, 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2 per minute into concentration taken, how much initial? आपको दिया initial concentration, initial concentration 1 molar. So solve, you get 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2 moles per liter per minute. It's your answer of first part. Now coming on second part of bit, second bit of question, rate after 600 seconds. Let us find for this reaction T half. What is half life? 0.693 by 690 by K. What is K value? 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2. Let us coming how much in solving here. It will become plus 2. 6.93 into 10 to the power plus 2. From here, that will come how much in solving here? This becomes 69.3 10 minutes. That means in this case the reactant have concentration T half 10 minutes. How much time taken in second bit? 600 seconds. So what is in this case T half? So what is concentration of reactant remaining at time t? Concentration taken initial into 1 by 2 power n. So what is A naught given 1 molar? Half. What is number of half lives here? It is same as 10 minutes. So half life is 1, so it is same as half life only. So concentration remaining how much? Half molar. So what is rate of reaction now? K will remain same, 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2 into half moles per liter per minute. It is the answer of second part. Time 10 minute indicate same as 600 seconds, that is T half. In half life, what the concentration consumed of the reactant? Half. So remaining is half. So what is rate of reaction? Rate constant into concentration 1 by 2 molar. From here you get second part answer. Now rate after 75% of reaction completion. So after 75% of reaction completion, what is concentration remaining of the reactant? 3/4 amount consumed. So remaining is 1 by 4 or 0.25 moles per liter. What is rate? K 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 0.25 moles per liter per minute. Then agla part which hai, bit, last part hai, fourth bit mein, rate after 30 minutes. What is 30 minute indicating? 3 half lives. In 3 half life, how much amount will remain? In 1 half life, amount remaining become how much? In 1 T half, amount remaining 1 by 2. Second T half, 1 by 4. One more T half, 1 by 8. So concentration remaining how much? 1 by 8. So in bit 4, the rate can be taken how much? 6.93 into 10 to the power minus 3, minus 2 into concentration remaining after 30 minutes is 1 by 8 molar. That is your answer, moles per liter per minute. You can solve. So this kind of questions are common in your examinations. You finding rate of reaction after this much time, that much time. So you find the rate constants. If it is not given to you, for calculation of rate of reaction, we require the reaction rate constant and the reactant concentration. Zero can be taken initial concentration, so I take initial rate. At different time intervals, we can find concentration of reactant remaining into rate constant can give at different time intervals the rate of reactions. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now coming on next part. Now sometime in the questions the data is given to us not in terms of concentration of the reactant, specially for the reactants involving gases. For the reactant involving gases, the data are given to us in terms of pressure or volume. So remember, for the gases, pressure or partial pressure are directly proportional to number of moles, or by volume, when we take volume and temperature constant. And for the gas, volume is also directly proportional to number of moles when we have pressure and temperature constant. These two expressions we are using for gases. In the exams, we get questions. The data is given to us of pressure of the reactant and all products, if given to us in gas form, or volume of the gas in terms of number of moles. So for reaction involving gases, we can remember, already we have taught you in stoichiometry also, that for the gases you can use relation of pressure with moles or volume directly in the given set of conditions. Like if I write here, for the gas what is pressure? nRT upon V. When we have volume and temperature constant, you can write first expression, when we have volume and T constant, R is already gas constant, therefore the gas pressure or partial pressure of gases are directly proportional to their number of moles or the concentration of the gases. First point. Second point, for the gases gases, volume can be given by expression using ideal gas equation nRT by P. If we take here P and T constant, R is already gas constant, then for the gas, volume is directly proportional to number of moles. Then for the gas, volume is directly proportional to number of moles. So in questions, whenever data is given to us in terms of pressure or volume, you take them in same proportion as their number of moles in the chemical reaction. In the chemical reaction. So let us take some question practice on this point, on this topic. So write on a question. When the data is given to us in terms of pressure of the gases, question aapko diya hai, for a homogeneous, write on the question, for a homogeneous gaseous reaction, aapko reaction diya, A gas give B, C, D gases, A gas give B plus C plus D. The initial pressure was P0, while pressure after time T was P, full stop. Derive an expression for the rate constant, derive an expression for the rate constant in terms of P0, comma P and T, assuming the reaction to follow first order. Okay? So try this question first yourself. See the relation. So let's come on solution part of this question. To solve this question, in any case when data is not given to us directly, we find data in terms of A and A minus X. If I write, for example, in this case, initial time taken T0, we can have initial moles A, there is no product. At time T, moles remaining how much? A minus X. It produces 1 mole, give 1 mole, 1 mole, 1 mole each, so x moles each. The two data are given, initial pressure, initial time and time T. Now data is given to us in terms of pressure, not in terms of moles. The data is given to us in terms of pressure, not in terms of moles. So kya karega aap yahan par? Aapko relation dekhna padega. So you can take P0 is directly proportional to what? Initial number of moles. And P at time T proportional to total moles. A minus X plus X plus X plus X. Or I can write P is proportional to A plus how much? 2X. Now in place of A, I can write P0. So what we can write? P is equal to how much? P0 plus 2X. Or 2X can be taken how much? 2x can be taken how much? P minus P0. p minus p0 in proportionality terms taken here, or 2x proportional to p minus p0, or x proportional to how much? P minus p0 by 2. Then a minus x proportional to how much? In place of a, I will take term p0 minus p minus p0 by 2. So we can write from here a minus x proportional to how much finally? On so in solving here, it can be 2p0 minus p plus p0. So 3p0 minus p by 2. So expression of a minus x can be written as 3p0. You can check it out how it is coming from here. Proportionality. 3p0 minus p by 2. So from here you can find the relation of k 2.303 by time t log in place of a, we write term p0 divided by in place of a minus x complete term 3p0 minus p by 2. This expression we will write for rate constant in terms of expression in terms of k, t, p0 and p. It's the expression of the rate constant in terms of p0, p and t. Okay, so I hope it is clear. आपके दो तरीके हो सकते हैं क्वेश्चन में. एक तो क्या है, डायरेक्टली आप प्रेशर ले लीजिए यहाँ पर, या आपका एक मेथड आपका ये वाला आपको शो किया है यहाँ पर. इस मेथड में क्या होता है, हमने माना स्टार्टिंग आपके a मोल्स थे, तो a माइनस x मोल्स बचे रहेंगे, एक मोल से एक मोल बनेगा, सबका एक एक मोल बनेगा. तो x मोल डिकम्पोज होने पर इसका x मोल्स बनेगा, इसका x मोल्स बनेगा और इसका x मोल्स बनेगा. अब क्या है, प्रोपोर्शनलिटी क्या है, प्रेशर का मोल्स से साथ होगा. p0 प्रोपोर्शनल टू a अलोन एंड p इज प्रेशर एट टाइम t प्रोपोर्शनल टू टोटल नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ ऑल द गैसेस. तो ये लिखना होगा a प्लस 2x. हम क्या करते हैं कि रिप्लेस द टर्म a बाय p0. So we can find relation of 2x proportional to p minus p0 or x proportional to p minus p0 by 2. तो हमें निकालना है a minus x, हमें निकालना क्या है यहाँ पर, expression a minus x के लिए वो कितना आएगा. We put in place of a p0 and in place of x the complete term p minus p0 by 2. तो इसको आप अगर simplify कर दें तो क्या आपको मिलेगा इसमें 2p0 plus 3p0 minus p by 2. So we replace term a upon a minus x in terms of these values. I hope you are getting this point. Since we are finding that a upon a minus x kitna hoga, p0 by 3p0 minus p into 2. So we replace the term a upon a minus x in the first order reaction in terms of pressure. मेथड नंबर वन. एक हो सकता है मेथड यहां पर क्या, वी कैन राइट डायरेक्टली पी जीरो एंड एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ प्रेशर. तो एनीवे इट इज फर्स्ट मेथड, लेट अस नाउ सी सेकंड मेथड आल्सो. सो इन सॉल्विंग द सेम क्वेश्चन आई नाउ कैन टेक सेकंड मेथड. वी टेक प्रेशर टेकन पी जीरो इनिशियल, पी जीरो माइनस पी स्मॉल पी इज डिक्रीजिंग प्रेशर, पी 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 देयर प्रेशर डिक्रीज गिव प्रेशर ऑफ B, C, D equal. Now given total pressure is how much? Total pressure can be taken. Sir, add कर लीजिए. Now P0 plus 2P is equal to capital P. Pressure is P after time T. From here, what is small P? It can be taken P0 minus p by 2. Now for expression of the case, this can be taken equivalent to a, this can be taken equivalent to a minus x, this can be taken equivalent to a minus x. What is p0 minus p? p0 minus p, so it is equal to how much? p0 minus, what is p expression? p0 minus p by 2. This expression come how much here? 3p0 minus p by 2. सिंपल तरीका है. फिर यहां से हम क्या निकालेंगे? एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द रेट कांस्टेंट 2.303 बाय टी. इफ यू टेक लॉग बेस 10 इन प्लेस ऑफ ए, वी विल टेक दैट टू p0 डिवाइड बाय p0 माइनस पी. दैट इज हाउ मच? 2.303 बाय टी लॉग in place of p0 means we write this complete term. p0 minus p is equal to this value 3p0 minus p by 2. We get same answer, same expression finally. 2p0 minus divided by 3p0 minus p in place of a upon a minus x. So I will write proportionality symbols, or you can take directly pressure values in solving such questions. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Let us take some questions more on this concept. So write next question. The decomposition of Cl2O7 in gas phase. The decomposition of Cl2O7 in gas phase at 400 Kelvin temperature follows first order kinetics. Full stop. After 55 seconds at 400 Kelvin temperature, the pressure of reaction mixture increase from 0.62 atmosphere to 1.88 atmosphere. Full stop. Calculate the rate constant of the reaction and total pressure after 100 seconds. Okay. So read the question carefully and try this question yourself. Now coming on solution part of this question. To solve this question, we write the reaction first. आपको question solve करना है. अगर आपको reaction नहीं दिया है, तो पहले आप reaction लिखते हैं. Balance reaction. क्या दिया है? Cl2O7 in gas phase. क्या दिया आपको यहाँ पर? Cl2 and oxygen. It decomposes from Cl2 and oxygen. अगर आपको reaction नहीं दिया तो आपको रिएक्शन लिखना पड़ेगा इसमें. आपको दिया, आपको रिएक्शन ना दिया हुआ है Cl2 plus O2, आपको मेंशन नहीं किया बट ये देता है. बोथ आर गैस फेस. इसको बैलेंस कर लीजिए. क्लोरीन आपको ऑलरेडी बैलेंस है. व्हाट इज ऑक्सीजन? 7/2. दैट बिकम द बैलेंस रिएक्शन फॉर दिस डिकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन ऑफ Cl2O7 टू फॉर्म Cl2 एंड O2 गैस. Okay. Now after this reaction, what is given to you? Initial pressure. Time is 0. Pressure given is 0.62 atmosphere. It is only for the reactant Cl2O7. So initial pressure is 0 of the products. Now at time t diya hai 55 seconds. Pressure decrease by amount p. Dekhe pressure p. And 7/2 p for O2 gas. Now total pressure become how much here? At time t, pressure is how much? 0.62 minus p plus p plus 7/2 p, and that is how much given here? 1.88 atmosphere. कितना हुआ ये? 0.62 plus 7/2 p. From here you can find the p value. कितने का पी का वैल्यू यहां पर? 1.88 माइनस 0.62 इंटू 2/7. It is pressure decreasement of the Cl2O7 at this point. Now, initial pressure given, pressure remaining how much you have to find from here, and then find the value of rate constant 2.303. आपको टाइम दिया है कितना यहाँ पर 55 सेकंड्स. लॉग हाउ मच इज प्रेशर इनिशियली गिवन टू यू 0.62 डिवाइड बाय प्रेशर रिमेनिंग एट टाइम टी. इट इज पी वैल्यू. पी ये शोन यू कैलकुलेशन ऑफ स्मॉल पी फ्रॉम हेयर. तो वी कैन फाइंड द स्मॉल पी फर्स्ट हेयर. आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ स्मॉल पी इज गिवन टू अस. टाइम दिया है हम क्या निकाल पाएंगे इसमें. वी कैन फाइंड द रेट कॉन्स्टेंट. आप इसको सॉल्व कर लीजिए, चेक कर लीजिए. योर आंसर ऑफ द रेट कॉन्स्टेंट शुड कम 1.58 इंटू 10^-2 पर मिनट सॉरी पर सेकेंड. इट योर वन आंसर रेट कॉन्स्टेंट. नाउ टू सॉल्व सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन. टू सॉल्व द सेकेंड बिट ऑफ क्वेश्चन रेट कॉन्स्टेंट विल बी टेकन सेम 2.303 बाई के टाइम बिकम 100 सेकेंड्स. लॉग इनिशियल प्रेशर टू बी टेकन सेम ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट माइनस पी डैश. नाउ इन दिस केस द वैल्यू ऑफ द रेट कॉन्स्टेंट इज नॉन टू यू 1.58 इंटू 10^-2. इट इज नॉन टू यू. वट इज अननोन टू अस पी डैश. तो ऑन सॉल्विंग फ्रॉम हेयर we first find the value of p dash. After calculation of p dash we can find the total pressure will be how much here 0.62 plus 7/2 p dash. Expression will remain same of total pressure 0.62 plus 7/2 p dash because pressure will change, decrease in pressure will change in different time intervals. So on solving from here we can find the answer of total pressure and that should come here on solving. आपको निकाल लीजिए, सॉल्व कर लीजिए. You should get the answer 2.33 atmosphere. For this bit you should get your answer equal to 2.33 atmosphere. Okay? So I hope it's clear. Now next bit is coming here, method of getting order of reaction from integrated rate law method. For finding the order of reaction from integrated rate law method, how from this method we get the order of reaction. I am showing an example here of that category. Now in this case one data question given to you, the following data represents for the decomposition of ammonium nitrate ammonium nitrate NH4NO2 in aqueous solution giving N2 gas and water in liquid phase. Now you are given data in time in minutes. When time taken 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes and time infinity. And we are given the volume of nitrogen gas in milliliter 6.25 ml, 9 ml, 11.40 ml, 13.65 ml and 33.05 ml. You can complete the table. First write time in minutes 10, 15, 20, 25, infinity and then volume of N2 in milliliter 6.25, 9.0, 11.40, 13.65 and when the time is infinity the volume become 33.05 milliliter. निकालना क्या है, पूछा है पहला पार्ट. शो दैट द रिएक्शन इज ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. शो दैट द रिएक्शन इज ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. सेकंड पार्ट है फाइंड द वेलोसिटी कांस्टेंट. आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस क्वेश्चन टू यू. देखिए इन सॉल्विंग सच क्वेश्चंस डेटा इज गिवन टू अस एंड पूछा है शो दैट द रिएक्शन इज ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. यहां तो दिया है इन्होंने कि रिएक्शन इज ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर आपको शो करना है. अगर किसी क्वेश्चन में दिया ही नहीं है, पूछा है फाइंड द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन, फाइंड द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन देन हाउ द क्वेश्चन वी कैन सॉल्व. सो इन सच केसेस वी अज्यूम द रिएक्शन टू फॉलो ए फर्स्ट ऑर्डर काइनेटिक्स. वी अज्यूम द रिएक्शन टू फॉलो first order kinetics and find at least two, three values. At least three values we should find in practicality, but even two values can work up. Okay, we find at least three values of the rate constants at different time intervals. If all the values of the rate constants are coming out to be same, if all the values of the rate constants are coming out to be same, then the reaction will follow first order kinetics. If the values are different, then we say that the reaction will not follow first order kinetics. We try it for the other order reactions. We try this for the other order reactions. But since in your syllabus, we can get zero order or only first order reactions. Only you can get zero order reaction or only first order reactions. So choice is less for the paper setting bodies to give the questions on other, like second order, third order reactions. On that, you don't get questions. So anyway, first order, pucha hai aapko prove karna hai. Aur agla part pucha hai, find the velocity constant. What is meaning of velocity constant? It is same as the rate constant. So in solving such questions, in this case now for the N2S volume is given. We are given the volume of the product, not the reactant. We are given the volume of the product, not the reactant. So in this case we relate the property A and A minus X. आपको ऐसे आपको सारे ही questions में कोई भी data दिया है, आपको link करना है A से और A minus X से या A not and A T से. तो आपको volume को relate करना है. इसको हम write the reaction again. Let's say NH4NO2 give N2 gas plus H2O. Let us focus on your N2 gas. Time taken 0, it was taken A moles. At time taken T, how many moles remaining? A minus X moles. They give how much N2 gas? X moles. And at any time infinity, reaction is completed. So what is moles of N2 taken here? A. X mole decomposed to give X mole, because आपका balance reaction है, 1 mole से 1 mole आएगा, X mole से X mole आएंगे. अगर reaction complete हो जाएगा, पूरा पूरा होने के बाद, तो कितना मोल रहेगा इसका? 0. 1 mole give 1 mole, तो A moles will give A moles. So in this case, we can take volume at any time T of nitrogen gas is directly proportional to X, that volume at time T, and volume of N2 gas at infinity time is proportional to A. Is proportional to A. So we can find three values of rate constants. As I told you, kitna aayega hamare paas K1 ka value at time 10 minutes 2.303 time 10 minutes log A. A kitna hai 33.05 by A minus X. A minus X 33.05 minus 6.25 1 bit. K2 कितना है आपका? 2.303 by time 15 minutes log 33.05 divided by 33.05 minus 9. One more, we find the K. 2.303 time 20 minutes log initial taken 33.05 minus volume at the given time interval 13.65. We can find one more value, but utna humko chahiye nahi hota hai. So on solving, you can find the value of rate constants. On solving this question, you find the value of rate constants at different time intervals. If all the values of the rate constants are coming out to be nearly same, we say yes, the reaction will follow first order kinetics. अगर हमारे सारे के सारे values rate constants के same आएंगे, same आने चाहिए, या nearly same होंगे, तो हम क्या बोलते हैं? Yes, the reaction will follow a first order kinetics. Reaction will follow a first order kinetics. एक part हुआ. अगला part पूछा है, find the velocity constant. हो गया k का value. जो हमारा k का value निकाला, हमने rate constant का value निकालता है. जो भी हम निकालते हैं k का वैल्यू, वैल्यू ऑफ रेट कांस्टेंट, वो क्या होता है? सेम एज द velocity constant. Okay, so that way we can find the value if they are small difference, like in points, like 1.89, 1.90, 1.91. So you can take the mean value of the rate constant. Suppose K1 apply 1.89 into 10 to the power minus 2. Here apply 1.90 into 10 to the power minus 2. 1.91 into 10 to the power minus 2. Then you take average. Then you take mean value, can be taken as the reaction rate constant. Okay? So that's one approach. And delta of the gas given in volume terms, we can link with the property A and A minus X. In fact, any properties are given to you about this gases, or we can take reactions taken of inversion of cane sugar. The delta is given of the angle of rotation. Then we can take reactions of ester hydrolysis. The delta given of alkali solutions in reaction of hydrolysis. Or we can take hydrogen peroxide decomposition reaction. We can take solution of K1O4. This is this part we will explain to you in advanced portion to link properties, because in general in advanced they ask the question on that concepts. Okay, so for time being this topic we are now closing up to here. Next topic we are covering is your different factors affecting the rate of reaction. Okay.